And support and love for each other up into the air, and it felt
as a former bishop of the ELCA, I want to share a statement, just a part of a statement of our six Lutheran bishops in
together and lead with love. Try that. We gotta put one foot in front of the other and lead with love. Put one foot in front of the other and lead with love.
Beautiful. Here we go on this next part.
Don't give up hope. Don't give up hope. You're not alone. One foot in front of the other and lead with love. Oh, one foot in front of the other and lead with love.
Again.
You gotta put one foot in front of the other and lead with love.
We got
one foot in front of the
other, and we
make our time. Sorry.
For peace.
We're marching.
We're marching.
For peace.
For peace.
For peace.
Deportation.
Education, not deportation.
Education, not deportation.
Dreaded millennials, particularly the college and high school students. Can you really show me how you show up? Can you make some noise? High school and college students. It's up to us. So we need to march, we need to vote, we need to make and grow beautiful things. And there's just one other thing I want to say before I go. We also have to find a way to talk. It reminded me the degree to which we're all in this thing together. America, this grand experiment is hard work, and we're black on black crime. But you don't speak out about the male pandemic of violence in this country.
The intersecting identities of women and the necessity of centering the leadership of the most marginalized among us. The Women's March movement is not simply about the well-being of women. It's about the well-being of all people, especially those most marginalized and least represented in our current political system. increase in both diversity and youthfulness. While the United States is expected to
America, they commit to get out the vote in 2018. We are the leaders that we are.
Women of many Western countries are often forgotten, and they can no longer be ignored. It is our solemn duty as citizens of the world to protect all of those who inhabit it so that they too can thrive.
I asked my sister,
will you come with me?
I asked my brother,
will you come with me?
Will you come with me?
I asked my brother,
will you come with me?
Will you come with me? I asked my brother,
will you come with me?
Missions or conservation outreach, that we have been left out, invisible. In collaboration with your male counterparts, I see that you reach out instead of up. As the kids and husband are gone, you suddenly are unsure of what to buy in the grocery store. You won't know what you like to eat.
Wait, I was able to go to college, and now I'm able to make a change in other people's lives. This isn't about me. This is about everyone here collectively.
We were meant to be now. We were not meant to be alone. We need to be better about listening and amplifying.
Registration information. Please come up with Elaine Berry after this event and read your state's website. And sign up for something called Turbo Vote. Remember that, Turbo Vote.
My brother!